Stevie T Films. Another day in my gaming room. What to do today? Oh, I might as well do a vlog today. Let's go and do a vlog. Let's go.
Can I come too?
It's a vlog. 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 I swear I'm a good vlogger. Anyways, hi, I'm Stephen Wilkins, Stevie Films. It's a vlog. Before we kick off the vlog, I just want to quickly say sorry for the lighting. It just came sunny right now. Well, it's going down a bit now. But, you know, the lighting is going to be on and off for this vlog, so who knows. So just want to keep that in mind because it's quite really sunny today, even though it's meant to be on and off rain and thunderstorming. Who knows? It was raining yesterday when I... Well, semi-raining when I was out. But, you know, that's the weather for years in British weather. Anyways, enough about the weather. So for this vlog in general, I picked up some various things throughout turning this week, even though originally, though, that I was going to get a job lot last week, this week, kind of, because I was eyeing up on it, but it was sadly gone. And so I ended up deciding to pick up something instead, because I've been eyeing up on something. Once in eyeing up on something, I was unsure about what to get from the Facebook Marketplace, and I recall on someone's stall on the car boot sale, because I do go to the car boot sale now and again, and I noticed some people that sell stuff on the car boot sale end up being on the Facebook Marketplace. So I end up finding this particular few games, well, not saying few games, some games, but the majority of these games are mostly Simpsons games. Now, there are two particular Simpsons games that I end up getting that are really good on the Xbox. And that is the good old Simpsons Hit and Run, which I know is a classic. But he said it's the only one they had, but it was like £10 this is. And this, however, is £10 also, even though that, you know, when it comes to Simpsons games, you know, they cost quite a bit. Let alone getting them for expensively cheap. Expensive-ish. Don't! You know, that's own thing. But, you know, they're quite expensive, these games are. And they are the best on Xbox. No! Go away! Let alone, no, there is that arcade edition one on the Xbox. Which I do kind of have, but it's delisted at the moment. Or different things. So I picked up these for £10 each, which is not a bad buy. Because they go for, like, whatever prices in your local CEX is a different topic, because they go for like £20-ish each, so I'm actually pleased I got these for like £10 each. And they do work though, they got some minor scratches, the guy did test them because he did the thing where he's like, oh, I'll test them for years before purchasing them. So yeah, it was nice that I got these because of I got some PS2 games off of him last time, man, when I was at the car boot. But yeah, it was nice of him to sell these for me. And sadly, he did have an original copy of this instead of the classics, but he's only got the classics version, sadly. Dope! Oh well. But I know I don't like my classics, but it's all I can do, really, because these, you know, things go for quite a bit. And it's best to get them while they're for, like, £10. It's another thing. Well, it would be nice to add to the collection, because... Funny which, as you may not know, I used to have this game before it went up in price at the time, because I kind of gave it to a certain someone, I'm never going to get it back, but nice to have it again in my collection, and I might, I'm saying play through it again, I have completed this before, even though I managed to do the final level of it. Excuse me, sorry. So yeah, other than that then, yeah, just great to own this again and add to my Xbox 360 collection. It's a shame that really it's not backwards compatible, it's all a different topic. Now, the next thing that I picked up along with these, because I asked him, because when I saw on a stall that I had some retro games, I asked him, do you still own them retro games? And he has. And I got them both for £5 each. Yay! Because I got this Sega Mega Drive game called Super Thunder Blade. And when I saw it on this side, like this, I was like, ooh, he's got a Sega Mega Drive game. I don't know much about it. I did look up at the end. It's basically like a helicopter kind of game, as you can see by the back here. it's a helicopter kind of game and all that. So yeah, it's a Sega Mega Drive game in general, and it comes with cartridge and manual. Sadly, not the Willy Winky at top. But anyways, I like to have games that don't have the Willy Winky on top. But yeah, it's nice to add to the Sega Mega Drive, because I rarely buy Sega Mega Drive games. And I thought I'll buy this because of it was only a fiver, which is not bad. The guy offered, which is good. And along with that, because another thing is there's no pricing for this in my local CEX or CEX in general. They don't have any listings for this game, sadly. Now, next things I picked up. Well, not the next things. The other thing I picked up, and there's a boy in his blob. Yay! And this game goes for like £10 in CEX, and I got it for fiver, well, £5 to be exact, which is a nice NES game, a nice clean NES game, comes with its sleeve, comes with a manual as well, which is quite nice, because it's rarely that you get manuals with the cartridges, there's the box in general, but yeah, he gave me this for fiver, for £5, so I'm pleased with that to add to the collection of them. NES games, well, game whatever that are cheap, so to say. Then is the car boot sales in general, because I've been to my local car boots and I picked up some certain things from my local car boots. I'll quickly show you. I picked up these bad boys, these headsets. Now these are, as you can see right here, it says right here, these are SteelSeries. Now don't worry, they're not sadly wireless though. This is a wired connection one, sadly. But it uses like a priority connector, which is this though, as you can see, in terms of whatever priority connector they use. And it does work as a head-to-head pair of headphones. And then is the mic is, I'm not so sure the mic actually works, because I've tested it on my Xbox One, and the mic is a bit, I don't know if it's the cable, because the cable looks a bit odd, even though there are bits like, well, if I quickly show you, that are a bit worn out and tangled a bit. As you can see, these look a bit tangled. But the best thing about it is, I got it for a fiver, £5, which is not bad buy, because they go for like £30 to £50 worth. For these headsets that are wired, £30 to £50. And I got it for £5, which is a great buy. Now, it does look a bit worn out, though. The bands look a bit worn out. But, yeah, the fun thing is, though, they are really comfortable, though. Because this band at the top doesn't dig in, and these are memory foam headphones, they just really look really comfortable. Now, I look ridiculous whatever headsets I own. But yeah, I'm gonna use these as my Discord chat headphones, because usually I just use like a pair of earbuds when I chat on Discord, and I'll use these because they are quite comfortable, really comfortable. And I know a certain someone who owns the wireless version of these. I'm gonna understand why she picked them, because then, you know, they are quite comfortable, to be fair. Sadly about the cable though, that's a bit, but I've ordered like another cable for £5 that's blue, and also because you can replace these bands as well, and I found one that has a SteelSeries logo on them, so I found that for £10 I'm going to replace. Like, ordering stuff on Amazon is a different thing, because I've ordered some things on Amazon, and I'm going to be replacing this particular controller. Now, bet you're wondering why, because I don't like the customization of this, and as you can see by the gold-plated button there, it's a bit worn out. But it does work, however, because it's an actual official Xbox One S controller that's Bluetooth capabilities and all that potato, you know, it's one of them sort of controllers. But I don't like the look of it. So I don't like the look of it. And it's made by, as you can see by the back, Custom Controllers UK. So you know it's a good brand. By that I mean a custom good brand. But I'm going to replace the casing on this, sadly, because I don't like the look of it. But however, I got this for £5. £5. And I'm going to spend a bit extra just to replace the gubbins out of there. Because I'm going to take the in the guts out of it and basically replace the casing out of it and make my own one. Which I might do a vlog about when I come back from my vlog hiatus and show you guys the final form of what I'm planning to do, because I'm going to order some bits and bobs. Quite cheap though, some semi-cheap. Well, the housing, the back housing of it is going to come from Japan, China, you know. So hopefully that's a good durability. If not, I have a backup plan. I do have this spare Xbox One controller that I do have laying around. That's only £1, but the reason why it's £1 because it's really defective. But it does have replacement buttons I can always use, because I need these faceplate buttons for, and also the start and select. Because you can buy some XYBA type buttons, but I might utilize these ones because I have no use of this pound controller, despite it doesn't have a backplate and it's defective. I've tested it though, which is, it is defective. No wonder why this was £1. This was during, like, I don't know, 2 years after the Xbox One came out. But yeah, I got this like in a pawnbroker shop. But yeah, it's just one of them things that it's defective. I mean, you can hear something's rattling in there. Anyways, speaking about controllers, even though that I was going to pick up a copy of Turok 2 on the Nintendo Switch. Now, I bet you're wondering, but you already kind of own it. I do own it digitally, but I stumbled across this that's like £10 at first, but it wasn't actually £10. And the guy said it was a bit scruff on the writing. It was meant to be £15.99. So I didn't have enough of the time, because I ended up getting Killer Instinct instead and didn't have enough of that game as well. So I waited a week. And then the week has passed, and it's this week in general. It was gone, sadly. So instead, though, I ended up stumbling across this by going to my local cash converters. And before seeing my services this week, because I'm trying to take advantage of when I do see my services each and every week. I'm trying to do like a fortnight thing and going to all my shops. Well, not seeing all my shops. I'm still taking baby steps to go to certain shops. But lately though, since I've been going to see my services and I'm taking baby steps, I thought I'd go to my local and cash converters again. And I picked up this, a Wiimote. What can you do with a Wiimote? I got this for £6, and it actually works this time. It works this time. The reason behind that is because I did have a controller before from cash converters, a Wii remote from cash converters for £10, and didn't work. And I couldn't be bothered to take it back because I'm a bit not very good at negotiating. Like, it's broken. Can I have money back? You know. Anxiety, not because of my anxiety, it's just how I am. Because I now own two working Wii remotes. Because when I bought some, well, I'm not saying I bought, my mum was nice enough to go, this was during 2020, to get like a Wiimote for £20, a working one that's workable, that they tested in my local CES. And these things cost about £20, it's an old different topic. So I ended up getting like one for £6. I now have two working Wii remotes that are white. One that's gold and the good old Sonic screwdriver Wiimote that I have right next to my Wii. Because I got two Wiis, you know. One that's upstairs in my retro. Well, it's kind of retro-ish at some point. But it's upstairs in my room. And I got this one that I use now and again, which is on the side of my desk, as most of you did not know. But yeah, it's nice to add another Wiimote in case I need to utilise any friends. That is, if I do have any friends to play with, sadly. But you get the idea either way. But it's good to have multiple controllers, even though I have too many controllers for my Nintendo Switch, is a different topic. But yeah, those are kind of the pickups, some nice cheap pickups I picked up, and looking forward to hopefully go to my local car boot sales, because I don't know how long they're going to last, though, because it is September, and they're going to close off the car boot sale season at some point. So I look forward to getting one of the pickups, hopefully this weekend. And that's if it is going on this weekend, it's all different topic, because the weather's just been on and off. And sorry in advance for the lighting again. It's just been on and off. Sunny, not sunny. Raining, not raining. Thunderstorms and all that jazz. So quite quickly, what I've been up to this past 1 week, even though, just what I quickly mention, I will be taking a vlogitis now, even though that I was unsure to do this vlog. One thing I'm unsure to do this vlog is just that £30 job lot was gone. I was going to do a vlog about that, but I'm pleased enough to find these particular gains for £10 each to make a vlog about it. It's all different topping and some other gubbins I picked up on my travels, as I do, because it's what I do. But some things kind of put me off a bit, in terms of not just picking stuff up, but some things do put me off, and, you know, things happen. But I'm seeing my services each and every single week to sort some things out, even though in future I might have to do something in future in general for myself that I might have to do myself eventually, because I'm getting a bit older, it's all different topic, because, you know, I'm now blooming 34 now. Other than that, then I've been all right. I had quite some things to do this week. I managed to do a video this week because of this past month sorted, because there are some things coming out, like the Yu-Gi-Oh tins are coming out next week, Slime Rancher 2 is coming out on Xbox Game Pass on the 22nd of September, and then I've got a filler video. And then before you know, it'll be October, and I'll be coming back in October for my vlogs. September 30th, it says in my notes. Sorry! It's good thing I checked my notes. But you know, I've got things planned out, then it is doing weather before October. And yeah, I've got not much to say now, really. Just been streaming. It's not a streamer, right? Don't forget I do stream. And doing whatever, I should say. Than is trying to do weather on the driest of days, I should say. Anyways, we'll leave it that now before I really go into tangent now. I'll leave it under 20-ish minutes. But I just got not much to say because, again, like I said, I was unsure to do this vlog and then do a vlog hiatus is another thing. So, yeah, anyways, we'll leave it that now before I really go into tangent now. I think I already said that. Anyways, right, I'm going into tangent now. So that was my vlog for you guys. Hope you're enjoying this vlog and watching and understanding. Don't forget to follow up on my social media as well. I've been up to. Anyways, let you guys get in with your day. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.